He is beloved of them. They are beloved of him. Simply the last step of his journey into work.
In Moyes we trust. From the start of next season, it will have to be someone else. A rather muted handshake from David Moyes as he has a good look round Goodison Park, which has been very much his home for the last 11 years. Thanks for everything, David Moyes. David Moyes gives Goodison his big goodbye. And what a response from the Everton support. He can't fail to be touched by this. Just over 11 years in charge.
Bowling Ground, Green Street, Upton Park, London, East 13, 9AZ. An address, a building, bricks and mortar, for a century and more, the beating heart of a community, the identity of its people, the manner of West Ham United. Payet. Reid! Fortune did not hide, and when Winston Reid scored West Ham's final goal at Upton Park,
full of emotion here, because this week Brian Clough did announce that this will be his last season here, which means that this is his last home match in charge at a club where he's ruled the roost since January 1975, during which time he transformed Nottingham Forest from a run-of-the-mill second division side to become the champions of Europe.
So many iconic players have built and embellished their reputations all the way through, from Alex James and Cliff Bastin, through Charlie George, to Ian Wright, Dennis Bergkamp, and Thierry Henry. Off his very long run, Thierry Henry, hat-trick! And he kneels down and kisses the turf in front of the North Bank. A history maker on a day of history. And Uriah Rennie is calling for the ball and calls time on Highbury. What a way to say goodbye. And now here they come, led for the final time by a man who has skippered Chelsea on many more occasions than any other player, John Terry. Nearly 19 years since he first appeared as a teenager. It's not often you get a moment that serves as both coronation and abdication, but this is one of them. John Terry has his Hollywood ending, and Chelsea are Premier League champions for the fifth time.
You know what, thank you. Thank you will never ever be enough, but I tell you what, I'm going to come back here one day. And I'm gonna be supporting this team and the players for years to come. Honestly, from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much. I love you all.
The footballing world craves one final glimpse of one of the true legends of the modern game performing on the iconic stage that he's graced for nearly half of his life. Steven Gerrard has set foot on the Anfield turf more than 350 times as a Liverpool player. He will shortly enter this arena to represent his hometown club in Liverpool for the very last time. It's farewell to a player who deservedly takes his place in the pantheon of greats at one of the most illustrious clubs in world football, and you can pay him no higher a compliment than that.
Just before a goal, before the tears come, as I say, I've played in front of most supporters around the world, but let me tell you, you're the best. And thank you very much, all the best.
Nearly 550 games since his debut in a League Cup tie against Southend. Mark Noble greets a West Ham crowd for the final time. East End boy, genuine Cockney, authentic captain of his club. He has truly lived in his dream bubble. He is beloved of them. They are beloved of him. And 16 minutes in, another opportunity to celebrate the man they call our captain. A moment in his life. Remember to remember this, Mark Noble.
Obviously, an incredibly emotional day for myself and for my family. I've got a lot of family here today. And when I say a lot of family, I mean 60,000.
It is the end of an era for Arsene and Arsenal. I guess it just had to end this way. A perfect final day at the Emirates for Arsene Wenger. A five-goal, five-star send-off. And from the fans here, it's a case of thanks for the memories, Arsene. And from everyone, it's a case of thanks for the football, Arsene.
Thank you all very well for having me for such a long time. I know that's not easy. But above all, I am like you, I'm an Arsenal fan.
His unmistakable gait and stride, his understated smile, his wave, simply the last step of his journey into work. In August, almost unthinkably, it will be someone else.
My retirement doesn't mean the end of my life with the club. I'll be able to now enjoy watching them rather than suffer with them. But if you think about it, those last minute goals, the comebacks, even the defeats are all part of this great football club of ours. And it's been an unbelievable experience for all of us. So thank you for that.